Let's discuss the electric flux calculation due to a point charge using a solid angle. We know that if there is a point charge plus Q, it originates electric flux Q by epsilon naught isotropically in its surrounding uniformly in all directions. And we can say that the flux which is originated is Q by epsilon naught, and if we talk about the solid angle in which it is distributed, that will be totally 4 pi steradians. Because we know that a spherical surface subtends 4 pi steradian solid angle at its interior points. To understand the solid angle concept in detail, you can just go through once again to the basic tools of this live physics galaxy portal, and there you can study the details of solid angle analysis. And here we can see that if at every interior point a spherical surface subtend a solid angle 4 pi steradian, then we can see when a charge originates its flux Q by epsilon naught uniformly in all direction and its surrounding, then we can see that this Q by epsilon naught is distributed in 4 pi solid angle uniformly. So here we can see that flux emerging out per unit solid angle from a point charge is, this flux per unit solid angle can be written as phi omega, and this will be Q by epsilon naught upon 4 pi, or this can be written as Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught, which is the flux originated from a point charge in its surrounding per unit solid angle. And using this concept, we can see if we are given with a point charge plus Q, and say at a distance L, we have placed a circular disk, and we are required to find the flux passing through the disk, which is of radius R, from the overall flux which is originated from Q. You can recall that a few sections ago, we already calculated it by using the traditional method of integrating electric field over the whole surface of this disk. And here we can say that the whole electric flux of this charge Q, which is originated within this conical region, will pass through the disk. And for this cone, if its half angle is theta, we can easily calculate the solid angle subtended by the disk at the vertex of cone, say if this omega, then this solid angle of a cone all enclosed by the lateral surface of cone at the vertex can be related with its half angle as 2 pi 1 minus cos theta. And in this conical region, cos theta can be written as L by root of L square plus R square. So the solid angle here is 2 pi 1 minus L by root of L square plus R square. So, in this situation here we can see, if we substitute the value of omega here, we can see that total flux emerging out from the disk is, this can be written as phi from the disk, this flux per unit solid angle multiplied by the total solid angle enclosed by this cone. So we substitute it here, phi disk can be written as Q by 4 pi epsilon naught multiplied by 2 pi 1 minus L by root of L square plus R square. So here this 2 pi gets cancelled out, and flux coming out from the disk can be given as Q by 2 epsilon naught 1 minus L by root of L square plus R square.